just a little bit caught in.
No one who had ever seen Catherine Morland in her infancy would have supposed her born to be a heroine. By the age of 15, appearances were mending.
I wonder if it can be good for her, my dear, to read quite so many novels.
Oh, why ever not? What could be a more innocent or harmless pastime for a young girl than reading?
Quite the young lady, isn't she, Mr. Allen?
Mr. and Mrs. Allen come with an invitation, Catherine. We would like you to accompany us to Bath for a time.
For when a young lady is to be a heroine, something must and will happen to throw adventure in her way.
So many people. I wonder who they can be and what their stories are.
Sydney, hang on. Is there anyone here?
Not a soul, John. There's no one here at all.
What could you mean?
Allow me to present to you Mr. Henry Tilney.
Delighted to make your acquaintance. And I don't
know why. His father's a man of consequence, though. General Tilney of Northanger Abbey.
Northanger Abbey?
Come my girls now, Isabella my eldest, and Maria and Anne.
I'm sure that we'll be the very best of friends.
Is it really very horrid? It is the most horrid, shocking thing.
Can such things really happen?
Just think of Lord Byron.
How can you be so
presumptuous?
Do you know that gentleman talking to Mr. Tilney?
That's our father, General Tilney.
He looks as if he were displeased with us.
It is only his way.
And is your mother here with you in Bath as well?
Our mother is dead.
My brother John says the whole family is very bad.
She'll bring a deal of money to her marriage. And the old man pops up, she'll be one of the richest women in the country. And I shall look forward to making your better acquaintance, Miss Morland.
Can you, Miss Morland, be prevailed on to quit this scene of public trial and oblige us with your company at Northanger Abbey?
Northanger Abbey?
Good girl.
It's exactly as I imagined. It's just like what we read about.
Let's just say that all houses have their secrets, and Northanger is no exception.
Imagine a city where everything's pretty.
I don't think the real world's full of murders and abductions and ghosts with clanking chains and seductions and everything.
Perhaps not quite so many murders and abductions. The broken hearts, betrayals, long-held grudges, schemes of revenge, fear, hatred, and despair. They're not part of all of our lives.
Welcome to mystery.
Shirts, stockings, cravats, laundry lists.